In this section, we will explore dealing with errors in our analytics, both from missing tags and errors within the source data. There are several reasons to resolve errors in analytics. The first is that the analytics service attempts to restart analytics in error states every 15 minutes by default, including analytics missing inputs. This can cause performance problems if there are enough analytics in this state. Another reason is that errors caused by bad source data within analytics can also hinder performance, and more importantly, result in bad outputs in the calculation results. It is important to build error checking into analytics for both of these reasons. The first thing we'll take a look at is PI tags that may not be present for all elements. And we'll take a look at fixing this by excluding attributes that are not available on certain assets. So first, we'll launch PI System Explorer. Then we'll navigate to the Elements view. We'll expand Sirocco, and then select Finisterre, and we'll select Turbine RB006. Clicking over to the Attributes tab, we'll see that our wind turbines have a number of elements in our example database, but one of these attributes, the local wind speed, does not actually have a PI tag associated with it for this turbine. So if you look through the database, you'll notice that some of our turbines have local wind speed and some do not. This is to reflect that certain pieces of equipment in the field may or may not have certain sensors. In this case, we'll select local wind speed, and because it is not present on this turbine, we'll, under the properties window on the right, we'll click the dropdown and select excluded. You'll see that the value of the attribute goes to excluded, and that this attribute now looks like a static attribute rather than a PI point data reference. Next, we'll check in our changes. Then we'll click over to the Analyses tab for the RB006 turbine. There you can see all of the analytics that are running on this particular element. But in this case, we're concerned with the local wind speed versus site wind speed analytic. If you highlight it, you'll notice that it has a pause symbol instead of a check mark to indicate it's running like the others. So this analytic is in a pause state. If you hover over the pause button, you can see that local wind speed versus site wind speed is suspended for the following reasons. Local wind speed is an excluded attribute. So this calculation is not executing currently. However, this does prevent the analytics service from trying to start this analytic every 15 minutes and improves performance. Later on in this exercise, we'll take a look at ways we could keep this analytic running while excluding that attribute. Next, we'll take a look at how to deal with bad data in our input values by using the exit function when that input value does not contain good data. So back in PI System Explorer, we'll click into the library view, and we'll expand our element templates, and we'll go to our turbine element template. We'll click over to the Analyses Templates tab, and we'll look at our same local wind speed versus site wind speed analytic. We're going to select turbine GE001 as our example element if it's not selected already. And we'll right click on our analytic and we'll say preview results. We're going to start our preview at today and end at the current time. That should be fine. And we'll generate results. If you inspect the source data, you'll notice that occasionally local speed, even though it is present on this turbine, has a value of comfail every once in a while. If you scroll through the data, you'll see that the comfails are spread throughout the source data without any regularity. So this indicates bad data in our source data. So if we have bad data in our local wind speed variable, there's no need to compare it to the site speed because the result that we'll get will be an error value and will cause issues in the output variable. So we're going to close out of our preview. And inside our analytic, we'll add error checking using the exit function. So in the local wind speed field, we'll add if bad val of local wind speed, then exit, else local wind speed. So what this will do is if there's a bad value in the local wind speed variable, then we'll exit. Otherwise, we'll use the value of the local wind speed. This bad val function will return true if there is a problem with the input, including both a missing tag or a bad state in the tag value itself. The exit function will stop processing of the analytic and save processing time if there is a bad value on this input. We'll click evaluate to make sure we typed everything correctly. And if we get good results, then we can right click and say preview analytic results again. And now you'll see if there's a comm fail value in local wind speed, like this row here, we don't get any variable for local speed or site speed because the analytic exits without further processing. Next, we'll check in our changes in PI System Explorer. We can also take a look at the same turbine we looked at previously, turbine RB006. So if we click back to our elements view and take a look at turbine RB006 and click on his analyses tab, we'll see that our local wind speed versus site wind speed analytic is no longer paused. It is now running. This is because even if an attribute is excluded, if it is wrapped in a bad val check, like our local wind speed is here, then the analytic service will allow the analytic to start, and the error handling inside the analytic will deal with the excluded attribute. So in the case of this particular turbine, because there is no local wind speed, it's an excluded attribute, the value at evaluation, the bad val trigger evaluates to true, and the analytic exits without further processing. Another way to deal with tags that are missing on some elements is using a not applicable tag. In this case, we have created a not applicable tag on this test system and we'll assign it to an element attribute. So back in PI System Explorer, under the elements view, we'll navigate to the RB007 turbine and then to its attributes template. Once again, notice that local wind speed does not have a PI point for this turbine. So next we'll click on settings to change the PI point data reference. And we'll click search under tag name. And we'll enter not applicable tag in the search field. Click search and then select the not applicable tag. Next, check in our changes. Notice that local wind speed now has a value of NA. This is a system state inside a digital tag, so this will trigger the bad val function to evaluate to true. So back over on our analyses tab, we'll select the local wind speed versus site wind speed analytic. And if we click evaluate, we notice that the value at evaluation comes out to a dash, meaning that this line here exited the analytic. But we will notice that the analytic is running and is functional. In summary, error checking, both for bad data within the data sources and in terms of missing inputs, is critical to analytics performance at a large scale. The badval function is a key tool for this. Both attribute exclusion and a default not applicable tag are valid ways to deal with missing inputs, but each has certain advantages. Attribute exclusion is cleaner in most cases, but in cases where there are large numbers of elements, it may be easier to use a default not applicable tag and replace the tag where it actually exists for certain elements.